Hello, ladies and gentlemen, I'm Kiran Bendigeri from Grafosyss IAS. In this video, let's have a look at 6th Standard Science 12th chapter, that is Electricity and Circuits. We use electricity for many purposes to make our tasks easier. For example, we use electricity to operate pumps that lift water from wells or from ground level to the rooftop tank. Electricity makes it possible to light our homes, roads, offices, markets, and factories even after sunset. This helps us to continue working at night. A power station provides us with electricity. However, the supply of electricity may fail or it may not be available at some places. In such situations, a torch is sometimes used for providing light. A torch has a bulb that lights up when it is switched on. Where does the torch get electricity from? We use electricity for many purposes in our daily life, that is to light the bulb and for AC, fan, and to lift the water, etc. And electricity is provided by a power station, and if there is any power failure, we use batteries and torches. Electric cell. Electricity to the bulb in a torch is provided by the electric cell. Electric cells are also used in alarm clocks, wristwatches, transistor radios, cameras, and many other devices. So these are the uses of electric cell. So one thing we have to note, that a group of electric cell form a battery. When we call a battery those are used in cars or trucks or in house inverters, then it is the group of cells. Cell is an individual thing, individual unit which produces electricity, and group of cells are called battery, right? Have you ever carefully looked at an electric cell? You might have noticed that it has a small metal cap on one side and a metal disc on the other side. Did you notice a positive sign and a negative sign marked on the electric cell? So there are two signs marked on electric cell. At the one end there will be negative, another end will be positive. In some batteries, positive and negative points will be adjacent to each other, separated by some insulator material. The metal cap is the positive terminal of the electric cell. Usually the metal cap which is there, it will be the positive terminal. The metal disc will be the negative terminal. All electric cells has two terminals, a positive and a negative terminal. So this is must to electric electric current to flow, right? An electric cell produces electricity from the chemicals stored inside it. So electricity is produced from the chemicals. It may be anything, lithium ion, or in big batteries like cars and trucks, sulfuric acid battery will be there, and lead batteries will be there. So these are the chemicals which are used to produce electricity. When the chemicals in the electric cell are used up, the electric cell stops producing electricity. The electric cell then has to be replaced with a new one. So when the chemical reactions are totally happened, I mean one chemical into another chemical, then it will stop producing electricity. Caution. You might have seen the danger sign shown here, displayed on poles, electric substations, and many other places. It is to warn people that electricity can be dangerous if not handled properly. Carelessness in handling electricity and electric devices can cause severe injuries and sometimes even death. Hence, you should never attempt to experiment with the electric wires and sockets. Also, remember that the electricity generated by portable generators is equally dangerous. Use only electric cells for all activities related to electricity. So, we have seen the caution board on electric boards and some electric poles, and also along the railway lines that there is high voltage current is going through the wire, so you must not touch it and all. Usually any voltage which is above 100 causes some or the other kind of injuries to human beings. So you should avoid those wires which are carrying more than 100 volts. And power generators like diesel generators and solar generators, these are also equally dangerous. So you should avoid these kind of things also. And also the batteries which are used in inverters and trucks, those are also high voltage batteries. So you should try to avoid touching it. The thin wire that gives off light is called the filament of the bulb. The filament is fixed to two thicker wires which also provide support to it. One of these thick wires is connected to the metal case at the base of the bulb. The other thick wire is connected to the metal tip at the center of the base. The base of the bulb and the metal tip of the base are the two terminals of the bulb. These two terminals are fixed in such a way that they do not touch each other. The electric bulbs used at home also have a similar design. So you might have seen the filament bulb. Within the glass container, there will be a positive terminal and also a negative terminal across which a filament will be connected. So that filament will be usually a tungsten. When the current is passed through the terminals, the filament get heated up and light is produced. Caution: never join the two terminals of the electric cell without connecting them through a switch and a device like a bulb. If you do so, the chemicals in the electric cell get used up very fast and the cell stops working. So whenever you take a cell, never connect the opposite poles directly with a wire without connecting it to a bulb or fan or switches like that. If you connect it directly, then the electric cells chemicals in the electric cell get used up very fast and it stops working. So you might have seen a bulb connected to an electric cell. So it is connected like this, positive terminal to one end. It is connected like this: a battery, one switch and one bulb. So negative to the negative terminal, positive to the positive terminal. Here cap will be there, here plate will be there, right? And these are also examples. If you get time, please go through it. And the same thing has been explained. Electric switch, we had an arrangement for switching on or off our home made torch by moving the base of the bulb away from the tip of the cell. This was a simple switch but not very easy to use. So electric switch which I showed here, so these are the electric switches. electric switches, right? And electric conductors and insulators. So this is the important thing: conductors, insulators. Conductors are those things which allow electric current to pass through it. Insulators, which doesn't allow electric current to pass through it. And there are semiconductors also, which partially allow current through it, like silica and all. Example for conductors, metals. Example for insulators, rubber, wood, plastic, etc. So the same thing has been given here. Your body is a conductor of electricity, therefore be careful when you handle an electrical appliance. So be careful. If you don't know much about electricity, don't try to touch it, don't try to repair any electrical instruments, because some electric equipments contain electrical parts like capacitors. Capacitors are sort of a battery which store electricity. When you touch it intentionally or unintentionally, the electric current may pass through your body and injure your body parts. An electric cell has two terminals. One is called positive, and the other is negative. So positive and negative terminals has to be there for any electric cell. An electric bulb has a filament that is connected to its terminals. An electric bulb glows when electric current passes through it. So it gets heated up and light is emitted. In a closed electric circuit, the electric current passes from one terminal of the electric cell to the other terminal. Right, closed electric circuit means electric current passes from one terminal to the other terminal. This is called closed electric circuit. So remember this point, closed electric circuit. Switch is a simple device that is used to either break the electric circuit or to complete it. So switch on or off, you have seen it, on off, to connect it or to break it. Materials that allow electric current to pass through them are called conductors. So as I said earlier, metals and all, those are conductors. And which do not allow electric current to pass through them are called insulators, rubber, plastic, etc. So this is the end of the chapter. Thank you.